All right, guys, Mikey here from Mikey's Iron Rage. And guys, do I got another banger for you today. And we're going to do it on the cut above the rest, Jay Cutler, at the 2003 English Grand Prix. And it's a pretty rare video. And if you guys have never seen Jay Cutler at the 2003 English Grand Prix, then you're in for a real treat. I mean, it wasn't his best look, but he did place first. Ernie Taylor placed second, and Markus Ruhl placed third. But that was it. You had those top three guys, and then after Markus Ruhl, the lineup went to shit. I mean, the lineup wasn't stacked at all at this 2003 English Grand Prix. And maybe that's one of the reasons why Jay Cutler didn't come in super condition, because he knew that he was going to win that competition. I mean, just look at the lineup card. The lineup card really sucked. I mean, like I said, you had Ernie Taylor and Markus Ruhl. Those were the only two guys that looked really good at this show. Now, as you could see, Jay Cutler's physique looks great, but he's not as diced. His legs are really diced, but his upper body, not so much. I've seen Jay Cutler in way better shape. Hams and glutes are okay. His glutes kind of suck. His hams are pretty good. Rear lat spread looks pretty good, but he just looks a little soft though, right guys? Very soft. But 2003 as a whole was a very, very good year for Jay Cutler. He did a bunch of shows in 2003 and looked fucking unbelievable at every single one of them and placed first at every single one of them, except for the Mr. Olympia because of the big King Ronnie Coleman. And that's why Jay Cutler had to get so big throughout the years, because Ronnie Coleman just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger. I mean, by 2004, he was 296 pounds. How do you compete with that? 296 pounds ripped. I mean, that's mind-blowing. It's very hard to compete with that. If there was no Ronnie Coleman, Jay Cutler would probably be 8 or 9-time Mr. Olympia, maybe even more. Who the hell knows? Because Jay Cutler had a very good career. And like I said, Ronnie Coleman was the only roadblock in Jay's whole career. But I digress. I digress. So guys, let me know what you think about this version of the cut above the rest. I mean, he looks really good, but if he was up against guys like Chris Cormier and Kevin Lavrone, he would have never placed first. I don't think so. And it's more of a popularity contest, in my opinion. Jay Cutler was the flavor of the week back in the early 2000s, mid-2000s, even the late 2000s. Jay Cutler was the flavor of the week. So I could see why Jay Cutler won this show. He did look a little bit better than Ernie Taylor and Markus Ruhl. But even if there were guys that were better than Ernie Taylor and Markus Ruhl, you know, if there were more guys competing, I think Jay Cutler would have still took first place. Because like I said, it's more of a popularity contest than it is a bodybuilding contest. I tell you that. Because there were a lot of years where Dorian Yates should have never won anything. But he ends up winning a shitload of shows from like 1993 on. With no arms whatsoever. So, like I said, it's more of a popularity contest. And there's so many other guys throughout the years that just did not look great and placed, you know, great, but they didn't look great. Just like 2007, Victor Martinez gets royally screwed. Jay Cutler comes into the 2007 Mr. Olympia super off. And what? Victor Martinez comes in super on and places second. So there you go. Right there, guys. That's the popularity contest right there. Victor was coming into his own at that time. But I digress again. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this awesome video footage of Jay Cutler. And if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Mikey's Iron Rage. Peace out, guys.